This video is about the simplest adder you can build, the ripple carry adder and its delay. First of all, let's see the half adder which we add the 2 bits with. We use a XOR gate for the sum plus an AND gate for the carry. This is the through table of the half adder. In fact, the sum is 1 only if just one of the input bits is 1, and the carry is 1 only if both input bits are 1. With an half adder, we can sum just 2 bits, but in a binary sum of 2 numbers, we usually need to sum 3 bits. 2 bits from the numbers plus the previous carry. In order to add 3 bits, we use a full adder which is composed by 2 half adders plus an OR gate. The second half adder adds the output of the first half adder with the carry in and in case produces a carry out, so we need an OR gate because the carry out can be produced in 2 ways on the output of the 2 AND gates. So, for example, adding 1 plus 1 with 1 as carry in produces 0 on the output of the first XOR and a 1 on the output of the second XOR because the carry in is at 1. The 2 ones in the input data produce a 1 on the output of the first AND gate, so the final carry out is at 1. In this way, we add 3 bits. As you see, by connecting 4 full adders, we built a 4-bit ripple carry adder. This adder adds 2 numbers of 4 bits, so the possible result is of 5 bits. The example, we add 11 plus 5 equals 16. Sorting things out, we put the full adder in a box and it becomes our elementary block. So the 4-bit ripple carry adder becomes this one. This is a combinational circuit, so it doesn't have a clock and the circuit operates as soon as the addends and the carry in arrive. So immediately when the data and input arrive, the combinational logic starts to work and to change some logical level. And after some time, which we call this sum, we have on the output a result. But this first result is wrong because we have to wait more time for the carry to propagate and allow the generation of the right result. So we need an extra time for S1 in respect to S0 because it has to wait the carry 1, and after another gate time we finally have the right S1. The same for S2, which has to wait C2 and so on till the carry out C4. So we have to wait more times for having the last sum and carry, so for having the right and stable result on the output. This time is called the delay of the adder, and it is the time the last bit needs to be stable. Here we see a ripple carry adder of 16 bits. As we saw, the delay is related to the carry propagation time, and the higher the number of bits, the longer the carry propagation time, because in the worst condition, the carry has to pass through all the full adders till the end. So the first sum to be stable is S0, and then all the others follow up to S15 and carry out. So the final result is available when S15 and carry out are stable, and for this purpose the carry in must reach the last full adder, and then we have to wait the last sum time, S15, or the last carry out time. A first approach to face the adder delay could be considering the propagation times of the logic gates to be equal. So the propagation time of XOR is equal to that of the OR and that of the AND gates. In this case, the sum time is 2T gate and the carry out time is 3 gate times. So in a 4-bit ripple carry adder, we have this time here. So in general, for the last sum, we wait N times T gate, and for the last carry out, we wait N plus 1 times T gate. So from here, you can realize better how the total delay is linked to the number of bits via the carry propagation. However, the logic gate delays are not all the same. You can realize it directly from the circuit and the connection. The XOR gate is the slower gate among these 3 logic gates, and the AND gate is slightly faster than the OR gate. I leave you a link in the description about the logic gate delay. In order to see the delay of the ripple carry adder, let's build the full adder in a different way. So, if we fill the through table of the full adder, we have this. If we look carefully at this part here, we have 3 input A, B and carry in, and the output sum. This is precisely the through table of a 3-input XOR, so with this XOR here, we calculate the sum of the full adder. If we now see this part here, we note that in order to have 1 as carry out, we need at least 2 inputs at 1, so this part can be obtained by this configuration with 3 AND gates of 2 bits and 1 3 input OR gate. Of course, a 3 input gate has a propagation delay longer than a 2 input gate. Anyway, we call T sum the propagation time of the sum and T carry the propagation time of the carry. If we build a ripple carry adder in this way, we can say that S0 is stable after T-sum and carry 1 is produced after T-carry. In order to stabilize S1, we have to wait the carry 1 plus T-sum of the second adder. For S2, we wait 2 T-carry plus T-sum and so on. So the longest time could be S3 with 3 T-carry plus T-sum or C4 with 4 T-carry. We have to wait surely 3 T-carry plus the longer between T-sum and T-carry, so in general we have to wait n-1 T-carry plus the larger between T-carry and T-sum. So if T-sum is longer than T-carry, this is the formula for the total delay of the ripple carry adder. Usually this is the formula used for the delay, but you should always see how the adder is built and derive the right formula from the circuit. As you saw, the ripple carry adder is quite simple in connection and construction, but if you need to add numbers of many bits, this kind of adder becomes quite slow because of the carry propagation delay. So there are other adders that face the carry propagation issue, as for example the carry look-ahead adder and the carry skip adder, about which I leave some links in the description. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video, make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell and subscribe to my channel.